A very good afternoon, my dear students. So here is the lecture number 6 of the chapter 7 equilibrium. So as usual, let's start with a quote, and the quote is, efforts and courage are not enough without purpose and direction. So anything if you want to do, the first the thing is that the purpose, you have to find the purpose of doing that. Then you have to find the direction, and then you need effort and courage to put on this for getting your purpose, for solve your purpose, isn't it? So I hope it is clear. So let's start with the homework solution on that which I have given in the previous video, and that is the value of delta H for the reaction X2 gas plus 4Y2 gas changing into 2XY gas. So is less than 0. It is saying that the delta H is less than 0. That means it is an exothermic reaction. So just keep in your mind, for exothermic reaction, the low temperature is favorable condition. So we have two things, low temperature over here, low temperature over here. Now out of this, one is high pressure and another is low pressure. So just find the volume. What is that? So here it is 1 volume, 4 volume, that means 5 volume, and it is 2 volume. So that means volume decreases. If volume decreases, it means pressure increases, and pressure is increasing in the forward direction. That means high pressure will be the favorable condition for this reaction. So what will be the answer? Low temperature. I hope it is clear. Yes, this is the high pressure and low temperature. Clear? Okay, next let's move to next question, and that is N2 plus 3H2 change into 2NH3. Kc is given over here. Kc is given 1.2. Now at the start of the reaction, there are this mole N2, this mole of H2, and this mole of NH3 in this much volume. So reaction will proceed. So what you have to find, it is in the starting. That means you find it QC. QC find kar lo, and KC is given. So if QC is greater than KC, then what is this? If agar hum kehte hain QC is greater than KC, then the reaction will move in the backward direction. Yes, that means the reaction will move in right to left. Or we can say that backward direction. Yes, but if QC is lesser than KC, then the reaction will move to left to right. That means in the forward direction. So what we have to find? We have to find the QC. If I will get the QC, then we can easily find. So let's start this N2 plus 3H2, and that is going to be converted into 2NH3. So here, initially it is at t is equal to 0, or whatever that is starting time, t is equal to t time, let it be t is equal to t time. Okay, so this is 0.249 upon obviously concentration ke liye volume se divide karoge to 3.5. okay, so let it be, let just whatever that value is given, just keep it in that one. So this is 3.21 into 10 to the power minus 2 upon 3.5 volume divided. And this will be 3.5, sorry, this is 6.42, no? So here it is 6.42 into 10 to the power minus 4 divided by 3.5. So just find this QC, any product concentration. So this is going to be 6.42 into 10 to the power minus 4, and will be power 2. Yes, 3.5 separately I am doing this power 2. Any issue with this product? Done. Now the reactant is N2, that means 0.249, and divided by 3.5 is going to be on the as a numerator. Then next reactant is this 3.21 into 10 to the power minus 2 and power 3 we will do, and that 3.5 will go up, power 3. Okay, so let's cut all this. So this is 3.2 power 2 over here. So what will this will be cancelled, and 1 will be left out. Yes, isn't it? And just solve it. So okay, so once this will be calculated, I'm getting it as a 504 into this is power minus 4 square. So it will be 10 to the power minus 8. And in bit like as a denominator, I'm getting 8.23 into 10 to the power minus 2, so power q 3, that means it will be minus 6. Okay, so all this solve, I'm solving this 2, so it is I'm getting 61.2 into 10 to the power minus 2, that means it is going to be 0.61. so now just check, QC value is less than KC value. KC value is 1.2, isn't it? So if QC is less than KC, the reaction is going to move in left to right direction. That means forward direction. So which is the correct answer? Forward direction is the correct answer. I hope it is clear. Yes. So let's move to next thing. Today we are going to start part C, that is ionic equilibrium. Okay, so ionic equilibrium, that means equilibrium will be existed in the aqueous medium, aqueous solution. So there we are going to learn about. Now let's start with the introduction. Before learning the ionic equilibrium, we should know that electrolytes and non-electrolytes. Although you people are very much familiar with this word, since class 10th you are doing this electrolyte and non-electrolyte. So let me just recap, revision thing. Okay, so electrolytes, that means which can dissociate into ions whenever it is passed through its aqueous solution. If we pass any electricity current, if it dissociate into ions, that are called electrolytes. Okay, and non-electrolytes which cannot dissociate into ions, that are called non-electrolytes. So chemical reaction in solution play a very important role in chemistry. For example, sodium chloride does not conduct electricity in solid state. Okay, however, when it is dissolved in water, it becomes a good conductor of electricity, and that Michael Faraday classified the substance into two types, that is electrolyte and non-electrolyte. So electrolytes, the substances which conduct electricity in their molten state or in the form of their aqueous solution, are called electrolytes because of their ions. They dissociated into ions, so that's why they are conducting electricity. Non-electrolytes, the substances which do not conduct electricity in their molten state or in the form of their aqueous solution, then they are called non-electrolytes. The best example, we can say any salt you take it, like NaCl, MgCl2, CaCl2. And non-electrolyte like carbon compound you can take, like sugar, urea, glucose. So they will be considered as non-electrolyte. Okay. Other example I have written over here. Any acid, base and salts. Any acid you take, any base and salts, they will be electrolytes. But non-electrolytes like sugar, urea, glycerine, etc. non-electrolytes, or any organic compound also, except acid. Organic acid, any other organic compound you can take, so they will be considered as non-electrolyte. So this is, you can see that HCl, when it is undergoing dissolved in water, what it is forming? It is forming H3O plus and Cl minus. HCl is going to break in H plus and Cl minus. So this H plus, since a water molecule are there, so water is having lone pair of electrons, so great affinity. So this H plus get attached to this and it will form H3O plus, and Cl minus will remain like that. In this way also we can see that any other ionic compound, if it is electrolyte, if it is undergoing, this white part is having H positive part and this green one is negative. So it dissociate into this and this green negative ion, and this is going to attach with the water molecules and forming H3O plus. Clear? Okay, so next thing is that polar water molecule. Polar water, why we say polar water? Because there is the polarity difference, delta plus and delta minus. So that's why it is called polar. So we can say that whenever it this NaCl, like we dissolve in water, what happens? This dissociate into ions, Na plus and Cl minus. And this Na plus get attracted by the water molecules. That is called as hydrolysis. Okay, so hydrolyze, Na plus hydrolyze ho jate hain, and it is surrounded by all that water molecule you can see over here. While chlorine minus, they will also, like this is oxygen, electron density high, here also electron density high. So what will happen? There will be repulsion, and that's why it forms like this. While here it is plus charge, in this Na plus plus charge, and here it is electron density high. So they feel like attracted towards, and that's why this structure will be like this. Got it? Okay. So these are called hydrated ions. Dissolution of NaCl in water example. Now, electrolytes are also of two types. One is called a strong electrolyte and another is called weak electrolyte. Strong electrolyte are that depending upon the extent of ionization. What is this extent of ionization? Matlab wo kitna ionize ho raha hai. Okay, on that basis. The electrolytes are divided into two classes, that is strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. Strong electrolyte are those electrolytes which कंप्लीटली आयोनाइज, वट एवर द आयन्स आर देयर, वो पूरे आयन्स में डिसोशिएट हो जाते हैं, आयोनाइज हो जाते हैं, दे आर कॉल्ड स्ट्रॉन्ग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, एंड इफ इट डजेंट डू लाइक दैट देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड वीक इलेक्ट्रोलाइट. स्ट्रॉन्ग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, द सब्सटेंसेज विच आयोनाइज ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीटली इन टू आयन्स इन एक्वस सोल्यूशन आर कॉल्ड स्ट्रॉन्ग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स. And example like all the strong acids, strong base, and the salt of strong acid and a strong base, you can say. Okay, so let me write here strong acid, strong base, and the salts of strong acid and a strong base. Got it? So they are strong electrolyte. Example HCl, NaOH, KOH, KCl, H2SO4, like this. And in this case, weak acid, weak base. Or salt of what happened? Salt of weak acid and weak base. So they are weak electrolyte. Like CsCCOH weak acid, NH4OH weak base, NH4 whole twice CO3 weak acid base salt. Okay, HCN this is also weak base salt. Salt of weak what we say. This is acid, weak acid. HCN is there, no? Not a salt. It's as HCN, etc. Weak electrolytes. Okay. Now note, it may be noted that equation for the ionization reaction of a strong electrolyte are written with only single-headed arrow directed to the right. For example, HCl plus water change into H3O plus Cl. So you can see that only single-headed arrow. Okay. Why? Because this becomes the again. They are so fast that we cannot observe the equilibrium in that case. Strong electrolytes ki jo dissociation hoti hai, ionization hoti hai, that is so fast so that we cannot observe the equilibrium condition. So that's why we don't consider it as a reversible, and hence we denote it as a single-headed arrow. Okay. Like HNO3 plus H2O also will it also give H3O plus and HNO3 minus. Whereas the ionization of such electrolytes is written with the double head, it should be weak. Okay, weak electrolytes honge, so they are slow in ionization. So that's why we can observe the equilibrium in that case, and that's why they are written with the double headed arrows. Okay, NH3 plus water again going to change into NH4 plus OH and NH4 plus and OH minus. Now, ionic equilibrium. Let's start with this, the main topic, and it is little tough than the chemical equilibrium. The equilibrium which is established between the unionized molecules and the ions in the solution of weak electrolytes, jo ionized nahin huye hai aur jo ions form ho chuke hai water mein, to inke beech mein jo whatever the equilibrium exists, that is called ionic equilibrium. Okay. Differences between dissociation and ionization. So this is abhi tak you are must wondering that sometime I am using dissociation, sometime I am using ionization. So what is that? So it's a kind of similar thing, but a minute difference is there. So just go through with this. Dissociation refers to the process of separation of ions already present in the solid state of solute when dissolved in water or a solvent. Got it? Ionization refers to process in which a neutral molecules which does not contain ions split into charged ions when dissolved in water. Got it? What is what I am saying here? Like in this case, suppose that NaCl is there. So what will happen? This will break and it will give you Na plus and Cl minus. So this is called dissociation. In this case, neutral HCl. If अगर हम HCl को water में add करेंगे, तो what will happen? This will also give you H plus and Cl. But very soon, this H plus will attach to this H2O molecule to give H3O plus. So final product जो होगा, वो आपको container में you will get H3O plus and Cl minus. Not the exact cation and anion of this electrolyte. So that is called ionization. Got it? Okay, so acid base concept, here we will understand on in class 10th also you have done the acid base concept, that Arrhenius concept, and there also I have explained little bit of Lewis concept. So here I will explain all the three concept of acid concept, Arrhenius concept, Brousted Lewis concept, Brousted Lowry concept, and then the Lewis concept. So first we will do that Arrhenius concept of acids and bases. According to Arrhenius concept 1887, an acid is a substance which dissociates in aqueous solution to give hydrogen ion. The one which gives H plus ion are called acid, and the one which give OH minus are called base. Acid will give you H plus ion, base will give you OH minus ion. So now you'll say, toh sahi toh hai, fir kya zarurat hai other concepts ki? So there are so many exception over there. There are so many acid and base which cannot be explained on the basis of Arrhenius and Arrhenius concept. So for that another concept is required. So that we will do later on. Pehle hum ise dekhte hain. So thus the ionization of an acid HX in water can be represented by the following equation. Like HX aqueous going to change into H plus and X minus aqueous. So here this what will happen, this HX, if it will react with the water, it will turn into H3O plus and X minus. Clear? So that means this is an Arrhenius acid as it is giving H plus. Clear? Here also this is H3O plus will be considered as H plus. It can be considered same. Okay, this is called hydronium ion and this is called hydrogen ion. Almost same they are. Similarly, the ionization of base MOH can be written as MOH aqueous change into M plus and OH minus aqueous. So this is giving base OH minus. So that's why it is a base. Arrhenius acid and bases. The one acids forms H plus in water and base forms OH minus in water. So this is the simple concept of Arrhenius acid. H plus dene wale acid, OH minus dene wale base. Yes. Now hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion, what are these? So hydrogen ion H plus or a proton. Why we say H plus as a proton? You all know that because it has nothing other than the proton. So that's why it is also called proton. So H plus or proton has very small size and intense electric field. Therefore, it radially binds to water molecule at one of the two available lone pair to form hydronium ion. This H plus H2O is here, electron density is yahan pe kya hota hai, it has intense electric field, so that's why it gets attracted towards this and it forms H3O plus. Clear? So here it is water and this is water and this is proton going to attach and it is going to form hydronium ion. Or hydronium ion is like this, H3O plus, or the structure will be like this. I hope it is clear. So let's start with this strong weak acid and strong and weak acids and bases. What are the strong acids? What are the weak acids? What are strong bases and weak bases? So thus, according to Arrhenius concept, acid gives H plus ion in water while bases gives OH minus ion in water. Okay. The strength of an acid or a base depends upon its capacity of ionization to H plus or OH minus ions respectively. Acids such as HCl, HNO3, H2SO4, etc., which are almost completely ionized in aqueous solution are called strong acid. Like you can see that HCl, it is having 1H, it gives H plus and Cl minus 1H completely. H2SO4, it gives 2H plus, it can give 2H plus and SO4 minus 2. So all the 2 hydrogen it will give. Next, you can see that H3PO4, all the 3 hydrogen it will give. And that's why it is called like strong acid. Got it? So they are called a strong acid. One thing I want to say that since H plus is called proton. Yes, H plus is called proton. So all that Arrhenius acid, that means all those which gives H plus ion are called protic acid. So Arrhenius acid, let me write over here. Arrhenius acid are also known as protic acid. Why? Because they give proton. Okay. And similarly, we can say if they are giving 1H plus ion, this is called monoprotic. Monoprotic. This is 2H, so it will be diprotic. Diprotic. It gives 3H plus, so that's why it will be called triprotic. Clear? Okay, So now next thing, while acids such as CH3COH, HCN, etc., which are weakly ionized in aqueous solution, are called weak acid. It is like repeated over here. Okay. So see, CH3OCOH we can see easily, CH3COOH, if we see that it has all four hydrogen, but it doesn't give all four hydrogen, it gives only CH3CO minus H plus, only one H plus. So it has four hydrogen but gives only one H plus, so that's why it will be considered as that it is not completely ionized and hence it will be weak acid. HCN, although it will, if you will just break it, it will give you H plus and CN minus, so you will say that here is 1H and it is giving, so why it is weak acid? So just to remember, I am telling you, all organic acids, organic means there must be carbon. If any acid is having carbon, it will be considered as weak acid. Clear? Similarly, bases such as NaOH, KOH, etc., which are almost completely ionized, are called strong base, while bases such as NH4OH, CaOH hold twice, etc., are slightly ionized in aqueous solution, are called weak acid. So how to identify strong acid and strong base and weak base? For that, in class 10th only, I have explained you, I have told you that if it is belong to first group, that means Lina, इनके अगर बेस होंगे तो दे विल बी स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस, अदर देन दैट इट विल बी वीक बेस. इनके अलावा अगर कुछ भी होगा तो वो क्या होंगे? वीक बेस होंगे. सो यू कैन सी दैट सी ओ एच होल्ड ट्वाइस, यू कैन सी दैट एन एच फोर ओ एच, सो दैट ऑल आर वीक बेस. Okay, so let's do some questions. The first question is, which of the following is an Arrhenius acid? Just answer first. Yes, Arrhenius acid, that means which will give H plus ion. So think of it, which will give? Yes, HCN, although it's a weak, but it can give H plus ion. Yes, and this H3PO4, so that can also give H plus plus HPO3 minus, or you can say that 2H plus can give you PO3 HPO3 minus 2. Yes, so it can give H plus, so that's why this is also the answer. So both B and D will be the correct answer. Yes, this cannot give H plus ion and this cannot give, so that means they will not be Arrhenius acid. Now the next question is, which of the following is an diprotic acid? Diprotic acid, that means which will give you 2H plus. Yes, so just think of it, that which can give 2H plus. Now you'll see that every here also 3H, here also 3H, here also 3H, and here so we know that 1H. So diprotic we want, isn't it? So here I want one thing I want to tell you, the H plus which are attached with H plus, which are attached to the H to OH minus, oxygen, that only will be released, got it? So think of it, ab yahan pe if it will draw the structure, so this is the structure. Okay, boron can have three bonds, so that's why if you will draw the structure for this, it will be P double bond O, OH, OH and OH. इसकी स्ट्रक्चर बनाने की जरूरत नहीं, बिकॉज इट इज वन ओनली, तो ये होगा नहीं. और यू नो द हाउ टू ड्रॉ द स्ट्रक्चर, यू हैव डन सो मेनी टाइम्स इन क्लास 10th ऑल्सो. हेयर ऑल्सो जस्ट लेट्स डू फॉर दिस. दिस इज ओ एंड हाउ मेनी ऑक्सीजन लेफ्ट? वन एंड वन ऑक्सीजन, एंड दिस इज थ्री हाइड्रोजन, सो टू विल अटैच्ड विद दिस एंड वन इज अटैच्ड विद द डायरेक्ट पी. सो दिस इज हैविंग two hydrogen which are attached with the oxygen, so that means it can give only 2H plus. This H plus will not be easily released as it is attached to the central atom, so that's why it will be called diprotic. Clear? Samajh mein aa gayi baat? So which is the correct answer? H3PO3 is the correct answer. I hope it is clear. Okay, so now move to next topic, and that is Bronsted-Lowry concept. Arrhenius, there are actually so many acids are there which cannot give H plus ion, but still they are acid. Similarly, so many bases are there which cannot give OH minus, but still they act as a base. So what is the concept behind it? So for that, Bronsted and Lowry in association, they gave a concept, and that is called Bronsted-Lowry concept. So the Arrhenius concept of acid and bases were extended further by Johannes Bronsted and Thomas M. Lowry, 1923. According to Bronsted-Lowry concept, an acid is a substance which can donate proton, yani H plus, this is H plus, okay, while a base is a substance which accept a proton, which can accept a proton, got it? So the acid will be considered as donor, this is accept H plus, the one which donate H plus will be called acid, and accept H plus, then it will be called base. So that means OH concept is now removed. It is removed now. So it just simply depend upon whether it is taking H plus or it is leaving H plus or it is releasing H plus. Okay. The one which will donate H plus ion will be considered as Bronsted acid, and the one which will accept H plus will be considered as Bronsted base. Okay. In other words, according to Bronsted-Lowry concept, acid is a proton donor and base is a proton acceptor. This is the line to be learned, that proton donor, acid is a proton donor and base is a proton acceptor. For example, in the following reaction, HCl loses a proton, is an acid, whereas ammonia accepts a proton, that is a base. How? Let's see. This is HCl plus NH3. So what is happening? This is going to dissociate into H plus and Cl minus, since this is losing H plus. So that's why it will be called as Bronsted acid. And here NS3, you just check the product. You just check this. And in this case, you just check this product. What is happening? This is accepting H plus. Yes. So in result of this, it is forming ammonium ion. And that's why it will be considered as Bronsted base. Got it? Ammonia is Bronsted base. Okay. And HCl is a Bronsted acid. I hope it is clear. Yes, few more example we will do. The main advantage of this concept is that it is not restricted to the neutral molecules. Rather, acid and bases can be either neutral molecules or ions. Like in Arrhenius, we were saying that there is a neutral molecule which will accept the H plus ion. Yes, but here there is no restriction for the neutral molecules. Acid, base can either be neutral, can be ions also, it can be anything, not like there is no restriction for the neutral molecules only. Now, in the addition of that, there are certain substances such as H2O, HCO3-, HSO4-, etc., which are capable of donating as well as accepting the proton. How? I will show you. These substances are called amphoteric substances. That means the one which can give H plus as well as can accept H plus will be considered as amphoteric substance. For example, water behaves as an acid as well as base, as illustrated below. See, as a base, if it is like here, you can say that HCl and this is H2O. So this H is it is losing H plus. Yes. So that's why H2O is going to accept, and here it is H3O plus and Cl minus. In another example, we can see that here H2O plus NH3. So what is happening here? This is losing H plus, and ammonium ion is getting this H plus and will convert into OH minus. So here we can see that this H2O is here what? H2O is here accepting H plus, isn't it? This is H plus accepting. So it is, if it is taking H plus, it will be considered as base. And here you can see that H plus, it is losing, because you just see the result. It is losing H plus. So that's why it will be called acid. Clear? Any doubt? Fir se main ek baar samjhati hu. Here you can see that H2O. What is happening here? This is going to gain H plus ion, which is released by HCl. So it is going to accept H plus ion. That's why it will form. It will form H3O plus ion, and hence it is a base. In this case, H2O is losing H plus ion, and that's why it will form OH minus. So that's why it is called acid. Clear? Similarly, we can take an example of HSO4 minus. Like if HSO4 minus takes H plus, it will give you H2SO4. That means it is accepting H plus. So here in this case, it is acting as a base. And this HSO4 minus will lose H plus also to give SO4 minus 2. So in this case, it can act as a acid 2. Got it? So these type of substance are called called amphoteric substance. Similarly, we can see for HCO3. HCO3, if it will take 1H plus, it will convert into H2CO3. So here it is acting as a base. In this case, it is acting as a base. Now H plus, it will lose also. This HCO3 minus can lose H plus. So it will give you CO3 minus 2. So in this case, it will act as acid 2. So these are amphoteric substances. Okay. So here some point to be noted. That is, it may be noted that all Arrhenius acid are also Bronsted acid, but Arrhenius bases are not Bronsted base. क्योंकि आर्हेनियस ने भी वही कहा था दैट द वन विच विल गिव एच प्लस विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज एसिड. और ब्रॉन्स्टेड इज ऑल्सो सेइंग द सेम थिंग, द वन विच विल गिव एच प्लस विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज आर्हेनियस विल बी कॉल्ड एज कॉल्ड ब्रॉन्स्टेड बेस ब्रॉन्स्टेड एसिड. बट आर्हेनियस सेड दैट द वन विच विल गिव ओ एच माइनस आयन विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज बेस. बट ब्रॉन्स्टेड डिडंट से लाइक दिस. ब्रॉन्स्टेड सेड नो, द वन विच विल गेन एच प्लस विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज ब्रॉन्स्टेड बेस. सो हियर we can see that all the Arrhenius acid can be the Bronsted acid, but Arrhenius bases are not Bronsted base. Clear? According to Arrhenius concept, an acid is a substance which can give H plus ion. According to Bronsted theory, an acid is a substance which can donate a proton. Okay, so both are the same thing, give H plus ion or can donate a proton, that is same. H plus ion is also called proton, as I have already told you. Yes. Hence, all Arrhenius acids are Bronsted acid. However, there is a difference in the definition of base. According to the Arrhenius concept, a base is a substance which can donate OH minus ion, which can donate OH minus ion. And therefore, a base must be a source of OH minus ion in aqueous medium. But Bronsted theory requires a base to be a proton acceptor. So in this case, the OH minus, it is not required to be a source of OH minus ion. So we can say that Arrhenius base may not be the Bronsted base. Clear? Okay. So now we can see that this is the acid and base. How this acid, because it is H over here and this is B base. So here it is reactant. Okay. Acid and base are reactant. After this product, what is happening? This acid part is losing H plus ion. H plus part lost. So whatever left is there, that will be called conjugate base. Clear? So always acid will always form conjugate base. Clear? Similarly, you can see that base is going to accept H plus ion. So whatever the product is forming over here, that will be called conjugate acid. This is the formula. In short way, you can learn like this. This make the table, make a like formula for finding the acid base. See, this is acid will lose H plus ion, and whatever the left part will be there, that will be called conjugate base. Similarly, base will accept H plus and will convert into conjugate acid. Clear? So this thing, it should be very much clear to you all. Never like that. Conjugate acid will never have conjugate base. Conjugate dono ke saath nahi hoga. If acid is there, to jo left out part hoga, wo conjugate base kehlayega. और जो बेस होगा तो उसका जो एडिशन प्रोडक्ट बनेगा दैट विल बी कॉल्ड कॉन्जुगेट एसिड. मतलब एसिड के लिए कॉन्जुगेट बेस, बेस के लिए कॉन्जुगेट एसिड. इट विल नेवर बी लाइक दैट कि कॉन्जुगेट एसिड का कॉन्जुगेट बेस. डिड यू गेट दैट व्हाटएवर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन? यस. सो दिस इज द पॉइंट टू बी लर्न. और इन दिस बेसिस, ऑन दिस बेसिस ओनली वी विल सॉल्व सम क्वेश्चंस. वी कैन फाइंड द एसिड एंड द बेस एंड द कॉन्जुगेट एसिड एंड कॉन्जुगेट बेस वी कैन फाइंड. सो let's move to next thing, Bronsted-Lowry theory. Acid HA, base B minus. So what is happening here? Acid is going to lose H plus ion and it will result in formation of A minus. So this A minus is called conjugate base. Now this B minus is going to accept this H plus, okay, and will result in BH. So base is now converted into conjugate acid. So HA plus B, this is negative charged and this is lone pair, we can say here. So HA is again going to lose H minus, and this H minus will be accepted by this B because it has electron density, high electron density. So what will happen? A will be converted with this lone pair negative charge, and this B is going to gain H plus. So that's why it will form BH plus. Got it? Because it was neutral, it is not having any charge. Here it was having charge, so that's why H plus and B minus will be cancelled, plus minus will be cancelled, and there will be no charge. Did you get that? But in this case, there is no charge. So if it will gain H plus, what will happen? The compound or the additive product will have some charge. So that is H plus. Okay, clear? So BH plus. Acid will be considered as proton donor and base will be called a proton acceptor. Everything is defined in terms of the proton, and the only recognized type of acid is Bronsted-Lowry theory. So in Bronsted-Lowry theory, whatever the acid base, jo bhi hum explain karte hain, that is explained in terms of only H plus ion. So class, that's it for today, and I hope whatever I have explained that is clear to you. So next up is conjugate acid base pair and the Lewis concept. So we will more and more understand about the conjugate acid base pair. Few examples we will do for conjugate acid base pair, and then we'll move to Lewis concept. So okay class, we'll meet in next video. Till then, thank you class, enjoy your studies.